Welcome back. Okay. Notifications locked. Alright, so as you can see, I've started this. Now each week you get a key to get further in the side quest, and basically you wanna use a mercenary for the boss, essentially. So I've got some strong people here. Let's see, don't want to trade anybody else. No, I think that'll do. Oh, part of that is for synergies. To make the team stronger without having to use boosts. So I'm just gonna go ahead and get in here. One of the nice things about this is they don't all have to be mercenaries to get to the end. And also, when I started, before I got in here, saw that there I had 31% done on the other ones. If you just pick one random day and use, when you have time, sit there and knock out all of the lower ones, higher to lower. Either way, this month, I've been getting a bunch of shards. I think if anything, for my second account, I am gonna go in and farm the lower difficulties just so I can get all the helpful stuff. Because it'll be easier than doing the monthly quest itself for my secondary account. gym right back. Okay, that was messed up. This power game is ridiculous. Damage over time. That would have sucked. Try it again. Oh, and if you're thinking about skipping down here because you don't want to do the extra fight, and you don't care about the gold. You already got the achievement. Go ahead and skip it. But if you haven't gotten it, it's kind of, I wouldn't say important or necessary unless you want the extra special. I wouldn't even say extra special. I'm just having it all today. On the lower difficulties, obviously, it doesn't matter as much. You should grab a boost. I think I will if I do attempt red level 5. So yeah, damage over time campus are really shine in this. But I don't want to read it because I'm still on the path, but it's one of those where there's special attacks to get the bonus. But anyways, go down here for the extra fight. Let me back up for a second. It's only worth it for the first couple times, otherwise you can skip it. Because you gotta beat 3 Doctor Stranges, Rocket Raccoon, Hitmonkey, and Winter Soldier, and the Duck. And then, this is why I'm kind of not too fussed about doing the rat level 5, because since I'm only Stormbreaker, I'm only, other than the Awakening Gem, don't really need to complete that. But if I want more shards and more Sig Stones, obviously. So even though I'm gonna fight Doctor Strange at least one more time, got him and Rocket and Hitmonkey. He's on the B path. He's there. And yeah, so if you don't want that, if you've already got your three Winter Soldier fights in, you can skip going down there for that extra gold if you want, is what I was getting at. Otherwise, do it on the lower difficulties and you can skip that. Okay, I was wondering what those were. Okay, so I guess we're going to have separate targets each week. Because I haven't been on the forum, so... Okay, that's how we're going to get the extra cool stuff there. Because I want that profile pick. Because it reminds me of Gambit more so than Bullseye. Nothing against Bullseye, it's just... Cards like that remind me of Gambit more so. Okay, so whoever's on the target list, knock out them. Get... Okay, so next week, I'll get that. Get that profile pick. Alright, cool. So now I know what to shoot for. Another mercenary ranked up higher, but unfortunately I don't. But after, I think, next week, whenever the level up is, I'll have enough resources to rank up another mercenary. I'm gonna do that path, but I'm gonna try to keep this video a little bit shorter than normal since I just did the Cavalier single clear the other day. So I got a long one out there. So let's see what this guy can do. I was reading through this. It says he can only do one, so obviously we want that regen for a higher fight. Well, when I was reading through, why are you able to pick three if it says you can only use the one? Unless this switches when you heavy. I didn't read through everything. So I was just happy enough to get a third star. About some bleeds on this deck. goofy ass duck. Second path, I don't have to worry about it. The other path is a little bit harder because I don't have enough mutants ranked up, so. Have to burn at least one revive on this. It was only a 20% revive instead of a 40, but done is done. And there it is. That's why we needed to do it with Black Widow Deadly Origin. Does that answer the question of how to get those Daredevil exclusive picks? Ooh, selector. Didn't notice that on the path. Alright, let's see which one's the lowest. Three science, three. Okay, so Mystic is the lowest. All day. All right, so I was only five. Well, five better than none. Full tier five. 7,500. Shoot. We close to 150,000 by time to get to the end of the month when I do my birthday opening. I was going to do these crystals soon, but I think I'll just wait till that day and do like a bunch of crystals. So that's what, today's 11th or 12th. Not near the calendar right now, but, oh, for anyone that asks, I was messing around earlier, and I had an extra XP bonus. I know I'm at level 60, so it doesn't matter, but for the, when the day they, turn on the, and, like, let you get up above level 60, if it add any experience from now until then, I'm gonna have some hit my profile. But yeah, no actual boosts. And so yeah, learned how to get the bullseye targets, and then since. Deadly Origin Black Widow is my best mercenary. But also for this level 4, first one, if I was only gonna do level 4 or above, Black Widow Digital Origin would have hit it, because she's a mercenary and she's a hero champ. So, wait, that's right, I wanted to change. Yeah, get rid of, I don't know, I think get rid of Diablo and look for somebody else. But anyways, now the champion info. And go down to tags bio. Attributes, she's a mercenary, and then, same thing, attributes, she's hero, so, if you just want to, if you don't want to loot up, essentially, just grab someone like Black Widow Deadly Origin, and beat the crap out of the duck, and then, boom, you get all four. But for me, I'm gonna grab all these after I change teams. But I'm gonna end the video here. Yeah. So since I don't need to go down after Ghost Rider and hit that, it's only 75k gold. But I think I'm gonna swing through there anyways, just in case. In case that gives you a bonus that's like a hidden bonus, because I don't see any treasure boxes. So, I feel like just in case, I'm gonna hit that. Even though I got all the bullseye targets. But thanks for watching. See you in the next video.